In this video, we're going to be doing two side-by-side comparisons. We're going to be comparing discounting versus compounding, also known as finding the present value versus finding the future value. And then we're going to do a little compare and contrast to see how a formula you might find in a textbook is different than a function you might use in Microsoft Excel.
What I've done here is I went ahead off camera and set up my spreadsheet with some information. And what I'm going to show you in this spreadsheet are the differences between a formula you might get in a textbook and the functions in Microsoft Excel. And I'd like to show you how to use both versions in case you ever decided that you needed to. So in this particular case, we're going to be doing intra-period compounding. The formulas and the function for intra-period compounding and annual compounding are basically the same thing. You're just going to make a few minor changes to the formula so that you can use intra-period compounding. So let's do a present value. Let's say, for example, that you were to invest $5,000. And you were to let it sit for 10 years. And you were to compound interest 12 times a year, monthly compounding, and you were to earn 8% interest. There are two ways to find the future value, and I'm going to indent these two right here just so they're easier to kind of see. You can use the formula that you might find in a textbook, or you can use the function inside of Microsoft Excel, and neither one of them are particularly difficult to use once you learn how. So the formula, we're going to type an equal sign to let Excel know that we're going to be entering a formula, and then we enter the present value, and that's the $5,000 that you invested. So we'll click on the $5,000 in cell C2, and we're going to multiply that by, open parentheses, 1 plus your interest rate divided by the number of times that you're going to compound, in this case, 12 years in cell C4. I like to add a close parenthesis around that fraction just to make sure that Microsoft Excel is going to do what I want it to do. So we'll need another close parenthesis here, and then we're going to raise this thing to n times k. So we use a caret to do an exponent in Microsoft Excel, again in parentheses, just to make sure we control for the order of operations. Multiply that 10, which is the number of years, an asterisk to multiply, and then the number of periods per year, the 12, hiding in cell C4. We'll close that parenthesis and we hit enter, and we get a number. Let's format it in dollars just so we can be consistent, $11,000. And compare that with the Excel function. The Excel function is the future value function. So you just simply type an equal sign, FV, to start off the formula, and open parentheses, and then you follow the prompts. The rate, however, is not 8%. The rate is 8% divided by our 12 compounding periods per year. Then type a comma. The number of periods is going to be your 10 years, N being 10, and then an asterisk to multiply and click on the 12 periods, K is 12, and then type a comma. Now the next thing I want you to notice is the Excel function is asking you for PMT, or payment. We use this if we're doing an annuity, which was what you would have if you were investing a constant amount into this investment vehicle over this 10 years. So if you're investing $200 per month or $500 per month, you would put that in this spot, but we're not, so we're just going to plug in a zero and then type a comma. And next we have the optional statement PV. You know it's an optional argument because you can see the brackets there around the PV, and that is the $5,000 investment. So we'll click on the $5,000. Now the next one is type. That is for a for the type of annuity we're dealing with, because this uses the annuity formula at its kind of base, right? And it's not relevant for our current purposes, and it's optional, so we'll just close that parentheses and hit enter, and we get the exact same number. But notice that it's not exactly the same. It's negative. That's because Excel operates on a cash flow basis. Excel looks at it from a standpoint of cash flowing in and cash flowing out. So what we have to do is go into our formula and correct it by forcing it to be negative by changing either the PV in cell C2 to a negative or changing the entire formula to a negative. It doesn't really matter which one you do. So I'm going to put a negative sign in front of C2. I'm going to press enter. And now I do have the exact same thing. So that is how the interperiod compounding works using a function you might pull out of a textbook or off the internet versus the formulas provided in Microsoft Excel. What I'd like to do next is I'd like to do the same thing but show you how discounting works. And I've talked about discounting in previous videos. Discounting is just finding the present value of some future sum of money. So we have a future value. We have an N, a K, and I just like before. In fact, I'm going to hit pause and fill those in. Okay, so I jumped ahead and filled all that information in. And what I did was I just went ahead and said, let's imagine the future value is the same future value we calculated before. So we're going to use what's in cell C7 for that future value. And I'm just using the exact same numbers and discount rates as before. The formatting sometimes gets a little wonky, so we go through and make sure our formatting is correct. So the formula is almost exactly the same as the formula for finding the future value, with one key difference that I'll show it to you. So we type an equal sign, and we click on our future value that we're trying to discount, an asterisk to multiply, an open parentheses, and then 1 plus open parentheses, and we're going to do our interest rate, or in this case, our discount rate, divided by the number of periods in a year, 12 in this case. We'll close that parenthesis, close again, and then we're going to do a caret for our exponent, and then open parentheses, and here's where the difference is. We're going to use a negative right here when discounting. When you raise to the negative power, that's the same thing as dividing, basically. So we'll now enter n times k, which is 10, an asterisk to multiply, multiplied by the 12 months in a year, and we'll close parentheses, and we should be done with the formula. And as you can see, we get the $5,000 that we started with. And I'm doing this to show you that discounting just is the inverse of finding the future value. Discounting is the inverse of compounding, which you can see pretty clear right there. Now, the Excel function is the present value function. So we type an equal and a PV and open the parentheses, and then you get the exact same prompts you got when you use the future value function. They look and operate the same. Our rate is our discount rate of 8% divided by the 12 monthly time periods we're discounting. And then type a comma. The number of periods, that's N times K. That's 12 multiplied by 10. And then we type a comma. And again, we don't use the payment function. The payment function is there because this formula can be used for discounting a future value, or it can be used for discounting a stream of future values. So that stream of future values is an annuity. We'll enter a zero there. We'll type a comma and click on the $11,098 future value. We'll hit a close parentheses and we'll press enter. And again, we have the same problem we had before. Excel gives us a negative number. That's an easy fix. We just have to put that future value in as a negative. We hit enter and there we go. We have the exact same result we had in the previous cell. And so that's how you enter the actual formulas if you had a textbook in front of you and you wanted to do either compounding or discounting, finding the present value or the future value with the Microsoft Excel formulas.
Don't forget to hit that like button. And as always, if you've got a better way of doing this, show us in the comments.